Good evening and welcome. Today is the sixth Sunday in Auburn time. Our celebrant today is Father Brian. Please stand for the opening.
Amen. O God, teach us that you abide in hearts that are just and true. Grant that we may be so fashioned by your grace as to become a dwelling place of you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The reading of the Holy Gospel according to Mark. If you want to, you can cure them.
He said.
Feeling sorry for him, Jesus stretched out his hand and touched him. Of course I want to, he said. Be cured. And the leprosy left him at once, and he was cured. Jesus immediately sent him away and sternly ordered him, "Mind you say nothing to anyone, but go and show yourself to the priest and make the offering for your healing, prescribed by Moses, as evidence of your recovery." The man went away, but then started talking about it freely and telling the story again, so that Jesus could no longer go openly into any town. I had to stay outside in places where nobody lived. Even so, people from all around would come to him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you.
Apart from the physical pain and discomfort of this loathsome disease, the leper described in today's reading had to endure the humiliation and isolation of being excluded from the ordinary life of society. As the first reading the Gospel indicated, the leper had an appearance that easily distinguished him from other people and gave them a distinctive identity. Besides their sores, their clothes were torn and then he beaten. The leper was ostracized and unable to talk with others who were healthy in society. The leper had to talk to them from a distance and shout out unclean, unclean as a warning to people not to approach them. As an outsider to the community, the leper couldn't participate in religious activities, or any other social activity going on. Harder to remember on the individual, these stipulations serve to protect the community. The victims of leprosy suffered not only physical pain and disfigurement, but even more painful was being unwanted and alone. Since as social outcasts, people avoided them. Many of you will know the story of St. David and Molochite. Some of the younger ones might, but he was very well known many years ago. The story of St. David and Molochite was a story about a man who dedicated himself to care for the lepers. Molochite is an island in the Hawaiian group. So if you ever go to Hawaii, Honolulu, then go on a tour to the island of Molokai. It's about a half an hour's flight. Well worth a visit. Great place to visit. And many of the areas where David were are still there. Well, David moved there towards the end of the 19th century. And it has a parallel with the Gospel story and the book of Leviticus, because the people were sent there from Hawaii, from the other islands, because they had leprosy. They were ostracized. There they were to remain for the rest of their lives. hear the time of day. It was discovered what caused leprosy. It was a bacteria. It was discovered by a man whose name is now given to that disease. It's now called Hansen's disease. And Hansen's disease can be cured with a few antibiotics. It's only the last 50 or 60 years, 70, 80 years, that this has been able to be a cure. So going back to Jesus' time, Jesus saw the wretchedness of this leper's state, and he felt sorry for it. And so the leper's prayer, if you want to, you can cure it. This prayer is an expression of this confidence that this renowned miracle worker would cure him and rescue them from this living death. And as we hear the story, this place was rewarded. And at the compassionate touch of Jesus, he was cured. And Jesus' response was, "Of course I want you." A very important response. Because of this, I rebuff to people who think that sickness is a punishment from God. There are many some right-wing Christians who think that some sicknesses or some disaster is a punishment from God. Here we have this proclamation from Jesus that he will cure. All he wants to do, of course, I want. The fact that Jesus touched this uncomfortable leper shows that Jesus could ignore the regulations of respectable Jewish society when compassion for the outcast and the sufferer demanded. But on the other hand, the command to go to the priest, the offering, prescribed by the law, shows that Jesus acknowledged the validity of the Mosaic laws. So we have this thing, cured of his disease, but also equally important, he was restored to life, his family, to a circle of friends, and restored to the local community. Well, in today's world, there are people who are alienated and discriminated against. And somehow or other, that phrase has come into our language. He is treated like a demon. We use it for people on the fringe of society that no one wants to be involved with. The gospel has a key lesson that it teaches us that we are invited to accept such people into the Christian community, just as Jesus did. We're no one to be excluded. No one in the Christian community should be excluded. But this high expectation of hope and goal often brings tension between Christian values and personal prejudice, stereotypes, and fear. However, the existence of tension should not prevent people from acting justly and humanely. Fear and anxiety is not an excuse for doing nothing. So in our PC society, people are becoming more and more tempted not to intervene because there could be some consequences of being of intervention. But Jesus is someone who broke PC conventions. He touched the leper, which was a no-no in society. So Jesus' response and his lesson for us is to be little way to bring hope and physical health to others. Personal involvement rather than personal attachment is the call of the gospel. And so the cure of the leader shows the effect of reaching out to the alienated. The victim is now full of joy. Their line is renewed. They joyfully proclaim the good news of the cure, of hope, and of the gospel. They come with a similar urge. If you want to, you can cure it. We are asked to have that faith that Jesus can come into our lives to give us hope, help us to change, help us in our needs, be with us in our difficulties. And the interesting thing here is that whether the people find Jesus, he's in the places where nobody wishes it. He's now in the wilderness, similar to where the leper was. And so the people go to Jesus in the wilderness, in that solitary place, and there they are powered of the Lord. So hopefully, we will apply the lesson of the gospel and the dialogue between the leper and Jesus to our own lives. And we can say, Lord, if you want to, be with me, assist me, speak with me, guide me, encourage me. And as we hear in the gospel, Jesus' response is, of course, I will.
That they will enjoy eternal rest with the Lord.
Christ.
Thank you.
love the human race, and you always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, and we are gathered by his love. And when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, most merciful, we ask that you send forth they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the last supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up.
Through
disciples of the Lord. And at this command, we pray and pray that the Spirit is with you. Having feared upon these heavenly delights, we pray, O Lord, we may always long for that food by which we truly live, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Lord bless you all, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us now go in peace to love and serve the Lord and pronounce the good gospel.
Thanks be to God.